diagnosis of brain tumors. Although there is no specific or singular symptom or sign, the presence of a combination of symptoms and the lack of corresponding indications of other causes can be an indicator for investigation towards the possibility of a brain tumor. Brain tumors have similar characteristics and obstacles when it comes to diagnosis and therapy with tumors located elsewhere in the body. However, they create specific issues that follow closely in the properties of the organ they are in. Their diagnosis will often start by taking a medical history, noting medical antecedents and current symptoms. Clinical and laboratory investigations will serve to exclude infections as the cause of the symptoms. Examinations in this stage may include the eyes, ear, nose, throat, and electrophysiological exams. The use of EEG often plays a role in the diagnosis of brain tumors. Brain tumors, when compared to tumors in other areas of the body, pose a challenge for diagnosis. Commonly, radioactive traces are uptaken in large volumes in tumors due to the high activity of tumor cells, allowing for radioactive imaging of the tumor. However, most of the brain is separated from the body by the blood-brain barrier, a membrane that exerts a strict control over what substances are allowed to pass into the brain. Therefore, many traces that may reach tumors in other areas of the body easily would be unable to reach the brain tumor until there was a disruption of the blood-brain barrier by the tumor. Disruption of the blood-brain barrier is well imaged via MRI or CT scan and is therefore regarded as the main diagnostic indicator for malignant gliomas, meningiomas, and brain metastasis. Swelling or obstruction of the passage of cerebrospinal fluid from the brain may cause signs of increased intracranial pressure, which translates clinically into headaches, vomiting, or an altered state of consciousness. And in children, changes to the diameter of the skull and bulging of the fontanelles. Treatment. A medical team generally assesses the treatment options and presents them to the person affected and their family. Various types of treatment are available, depending on tumor type and location, and may be combined to produce the best chances of survival. Surgery. Complete or partial resection of the tumor with the object of removing as many tumor cells as possible. Radiotherapy is the most commonly used treatment for brain tumors. The tumor is irradiated with beta, X-rays or gamma rays. Chemotherapy is a treatment option for cancer. However, it is not always used to treat brain tumors as the blood-brain barrier can prevent some drugs from reaching the cancerous cells. Survival rates in primary brain tumors depend on the type of tumor, age, functional status of the patient, the extent of surgical removal, and other factors specific to each case. Prognosis. The prognosis of brain cancer depends on the type of cancer diagnosed. Medulloblastoma has a good prognosis with chemotherapy, radiotherapy, and surgical resection, while glioblastoma multiforme has a median survival of only 12 months even with aggressive radiotherapy and surgery. Brainstem gliomas have the poorest prognosis of any form of brain cancer, with most patients dying within 1 year. Even with therapy that typically consists of radiation to the tumor along with corticosteroids. However, one type, focal brainstem gliomas in children, seems open to exceptional prognosis and long-term survival has frequently been reported.